Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on getting started with the Avatar component in a Blazor Web Assembly application. An avatar is a CSS-based component designed to represent profile pictures, initials, or icons in a visually appealing manner. In this video, I will show you how to create a Web Assembly application and add the avatar component to it. You will see the different sizes and types of avatars. I will also show how to integrate the avatar component with other UI components. Let's start with the project creation process. Before proceeding, make sure that you have one of the following .NET SDKs installed, and one of these IDEs installed in your machine. I open Visual Studio 2022 and select Create a New Project. From the list of project templates, I choose Blazor Web Assembly App and name the project. I then proceed with the default target framework and click Create to complete the project creation process. The project has been created and is ready to use. If you want to know more about Blazor Web Assembly apps and how to add Syncfusion components to it, click the video link shown in the YouTube card above. To add the Syncfusion Blazor Avatar component, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor package. So, let me open the NuGet Package Manager. In the Browse tab, I search for Syncfusion Blazor and install it. When the installation is completed, I open the project dependencies and check the packages section to make sure that Syncfusion Blazor is installed. I then navigate to the imports.razor page and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace so that I can use the Blazor avatar in any of the components available in the pages folder. Next, I open the program.cs file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. I register the Syncfusion Blazor services by calling the addSyncfusionBlazor method. Then, register a valid license key in my application using the registerLicense method. To know where to generate a trial license key, refer to the link in the description. To define the CSS for the Blazor avatar component, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor themes package. So, navigating to the NuGet Package Manager, I search for Syncfusion Blazor themes and install it. After that, I open the index.html file and reference the CSS from the installed themes package. I also add the script reference manually to enable better loading performance of the app. The application is now ready to add the avatar component. I open the index.razor page and remove the existing code. As I said earlier, avatar is a CSS-based component and will be rendered if the appropriate CSS classes are added to the target element. Now, I am going to display a profile picture using the avatar component. To do that, I add a division element and add the class eAvatar. To add the profile picture image, I add one more class image. In the style tag, I define the CSS classes, eAvatar and image, and specify the source of the image stored in the application using the background image property. Save the changes and run the application. You can see the profile picture displayed using the avatar component. Here, the image is displayed in the default medium size. Apart from this dimension, you can also render images in different sizes like extra small, small, large, and extra large. Let me demonstrate how to add small and large-sized avatars now. I add two more division elements with the CSS class eAvatar image. To display a small-sized image, I add the CSS class eAvatar small. Similarly, to display a large one, I add the appropriate CSS class. Look here, the profile pictures are displayed in different sizes. So far, I have shown how to display the image type avatar. Apart from this, you can also display SVG icons, font icons, initials, words, letters, and custom icons using the avatar. Now, I will show you how to display initials instead of an image. For demonstration purpose, I comment out the other avatar components and keep only the large size avatar. To display initials, I remove the image class and include the initials GP in the target element. You can see the avatar is rendered with initials. By default, the avatar is displayed in a square shape. It can be changed to a circle by adding the eAvatar Circle CSS class. To demonstrate, I add the eAvatar Circle class to the target element. Now, the profile picture is displayed in a circle. Finally, I will show you how to integrate the avatar component with other UI components like card, badge, list view, and so on. Let me explain how to integrate the avatar component to the card component. I am going to design a card with a profile picture, name, designation, and profile description. For this example, I will use the Syncfusion card component. And in that, I use Syncfusion avatar to display the profile picture. Let's start designing the card. First, I add a division element with the class containerDiv. Using this class, I will add CSS styles to the container. Within it, I add one more division element, which is going to act as a Syncfusion card. So, let me add a predefined class, eCard, to the division element. This eCard class will add some default style attributes to the outer layout of the card UI. Next, I add card elements like card header and card content with appropriate CSS classes, eCard header and eCard content. Inside the card header, I add the existing avatar component to display the profile picture. As I want to display the image here, I remove the initial content and add the class image. I also change the avatar size to extra large by modifying the class to eAvatarXLarge. To make the card visually appealing, I define the required CSS styles like margin, padding, left, top, box shadow, and so on for the appropriate CSS classes inside the style tag. Check now, the card is rendered with the specified content and it has the avatar component for displaying the profile picture. Let me summarize what we have seen so far. I showed you how to create a Blazor Web Assembly application and add the Syncfusion Blazor Avatar component to it. You saw different sizes and types of avatar component. I also showed you how to integrate the avatar component with other UI components. If you would like to see a working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, do like the video and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.